Aki Karim here, BBTV. I'm here with the Black Flash, former British and European champion, Pat Barrett. Pat, just been talking to Zelfa there. He's got his world title set in stone now. November the 5th, Rakhimov, Abu Dhabi. It's come around quickly, hasn't it?
You know what it has. It's kind of surprising, but I mean, fortunately for us, we're always in the gym and we don't really stop. The only thing that we really have to prepare so hard for is mentally than it is physically, because I mean, this guy that we're fighting, everyone looks at it as a 50-50, and it is a 50-50. Fighting for the European was a 50-50. Fighting for the Commonwealth is a 50-50, because when you fight for the championship fight, or any championship fight, people come and they want it just as much as you want it. They're training just as hard as you're training. There is no disputing how much you can say to any fighter, how much you want to be a champion. And they're going to say, I want to be a champion, even a Central Area champion. So I mean, even an English champion. You know, they want that title so bad, they prepare for it. So between me and Zelfa, every fight and every title has been a world title to us. We've never looked at it as any different. We got so much respect for the guy that we're fighting that, you know, we're not just afraid to get beat. We don't want to get beat. So in every way, I have to make sure I do my job. I know I'm up against one of the best coaches,
Freddie Roach, yeah,
pound for pound coaches in boxing, which is Freddie Roach. So for me to come up against such a good coach, it's like, wow, you know, not being funny. I used to watch this coach a long time ago. I know I've watched him with Manny Pacquiao. I've watched him, and he's very good at training fighters. Maybe not kids on the boxing scene, but people that can fight, he's very good. He's very good with southpaws. Yeah, he knows what to make a do to try and break a fighter down to get close. And I've watched this kid, and the more I watched him, the more I can see a bit of Pacquiao in him as he's with Roach. The more I see he's with Roach, the more I can see he's holding his feet a lot more. He's not the kind of fighter that he was before. He has changed, and he has changed for the better. You know, the way he takes his time, the way he sets his punches, the way he uses the southpaw jab, the way he switches over an angle to throw his punches. You know, I've analysed everything, and it's like chess. Now, I've got to try and counteract that in a very smart way. So, we do know what we're up against. We're up against a very, very formidable fighter, yeah, and coach.
Yeah, it sounds like you've done your homework, and you're doing your homework. I mean, in terms of, you know, Zelfa, the southpaw thing, you know, that does bring extra challenges with it. You're getting some really good sparring in here as well. So in a short space of time, you're having to cover a lot of bases that you would do in a lot longer of a space of time, really, aren't you? So how's that?
I mean, again, like I said, you know, I mean, I look at it that it's an opportunity that's come. Opportunities don't come round a lot. You know, It's just so much that comes with things that you do and you don't like. But at the moment, you know, I want to just look at this as a hard job, getting there. And I know for the fact, you know, the better and the level that Zelfa fights, the better he's going to become. Because, you know, he's had, I think it's nearly, 29, 30 fights. He's 29-1. Do you know what I mean? He's had a lot of experience. Yeah. So what he didn't do in the amateurs, he's made up as a pro. And this is his time now, do you know what I mean? We're not taking nothing away. This guy is a good guy. And please don't no one say, oh, he's this, oh, he's that. He's a good kid. I've watched him. He's a proper Russian. He's tough. He's durable. He comes to fight and he comes to win. But you know what? So do we. Yeah. And there's one thing that this kid can't deal with is awkwardness. He can't deal with speed. He's a counterpuncher. Yeah. You know, it's like, don't feed him anything. To me, there's so much you can do, and this is all about being intelligent. That's all. It's not about what I do in the gym, training hard, and all the road work, and all the steps, and the sprints, and that. No, this is different. We're already fit. We've been fit for years. He's been training all his life, since he's been 16, Zelfa. Yeah. So you can't get any fitter. But what you can do, what does change in a fighter, is the mindset. This is what we have to build. We have to build this mindset to be, A, we're going in for something. B, it's going to be tough. C, let's get ready for it. Yeah. And that's all we have to do. The rest of it then will just come together.
Looking at his punch record, KO history, etc., it looks pretty solid there. As a puncher yourself, from when you was fighting, like, what sort of opponents did you find?
Who are we talking about?
Rakimov.
Yeah, Rakimov.
Very high knockout ratio.
Yeah.
So as yourself, as a puncher, back when you was boxing, what sort of opponents did you not like in front of you? You know, are there certain opponents that box, like, big
I can't
like
give that away.
All right.
Because if I give that away, it really states the thing that what we're going to do.
Okay, cool.
You know,
so
but I know exactly, you know,
what a puncher doesn't like.
Yeah.
Now, I've seen you working there on the core, a lot on the core. In fact, you was actually rolling back the clock and doing quite a few sit-ups yourself.
No, it's not about me. I mean, I was just accompanying Zelfa because he's in the gym by himself. And sometimes, you know, when you're not training with the team, because they've been in and out, and basically I've told everyone to come in an hour early, so I can work with Zelfa by himself. It also makes it more like, Zelfa likes to train with the team, take away the things that he does like, so it's just me and him, and he can focus. And Zelfa hates training with me, because I'm not the prettiest person to train with.
But I actually understand he's done it. He has actually moved in with you now, which is something he's been trying to put off for as long as possible. But he's done it. He's moved in with you. That is a real sign of intent. That. Did you say to him, for this fight, you've got to move in with me?
No. Yeah. I never asked that, because even when he fought for the European title, he never moved in with me. Yeah, we did everything in the gym. And as I said to you before, this is what Zelfa said. He says, "Can you come and stay with me?" I'm not going to say no, but I can understand why he wants to come and stay, because I've got one of these mentalities that, you know, it's very straightforward, very black and white. There's no grey areas, and let's do this. And as much as he knows it's going to be hard, you know, he's going to put up with it. And once he's staying, I can put up with living with my uncle for 4 weeks. I can deal with this guy, because it isn't easy. I'm very judgmental and very critical on the way you live, on the way you eat, on the way you think. I mean, everything you do in my house, it's like, no, put that back, no, don't do that. You know, there's real restrictions for everything. You got to ask yourself, am I doing something right here? What did we have an argument before out there? He was talking about I'm being negative. I ain't being negative. How the fuck can he say I'm being negative? He's stupid. I've been with you all your life. How am I negative? Are you daft? And that's what I told him. Come and listen, you fucking idiot. Don't talk to me about being negative. If I was fucking negative, it wouldn't be here now, and you wouldn't be here. I mean, because he doesn't like what I say. When I'm saying this, he looks at it like you're being, no, I'm not being negative, I'm being truthful. You know what I mean? If you don't like the fucking truth, then get somebody else that can blow smoke up your ass. You know what I mean? And give you all what you want to hear. I'm not his fucking cheerleader. Yeah. I'm your trainer. You know what I mean? Show some respect. You should know that I want you to win, and I want you to get there. I do, and that's what I do. I want it as much for him as I want it for myself. Because it's something that I never achieved. Yeah, he's got a better opponent than me. Yeah, do you know what I mean? He's got a better opponent. He's got someone that comes to fight. I wish I had someone that come to fight. I had someone that came to fucking dance.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And stole it. Don't get me wrong. He danced his way through to a victory, and he did right. You know what I mean? You can't take that away. But you know, he's got someone that comes to that wants to fight, and he'll come to fight, and he'll throw big shots, and that's it. When you've got ability and you've got skill and you've got a good mindset and, you know, you box from this, not from this, yeah, you've got a lot.
And
his opponent is an intelligent fighter, but he's also, there's a point where I see that makes him limited to an extent.
And you mentioned there, like, obviously, you know, being the critical, he's living with you, etc. But at the same time, has it given you an opportunity to sort of bond a little bit and cement that trainer and fighter relationship as well?
No, we and Zelf always going to have this kind of relationship. We've always had the same relationship. It's never going to change.
Yeah.
It's who we are.
I know, yeah.
It's who we are. It doesn't get any easier as he gets older, because all he is a fucking man. You know what I mean? And he's a dad. Do you know what I mean? So it, you know, got to give respect where respect is due. He is a man, and he is a father. And sometimes, yeah, you know what? Okay, I do have to change certain ways and how I will put up with things. So he's going to make his own decision, right or wrong. He's going to have to make that. But as long as he knows, that's his responsibility. But you know what? We do work pretty well. We do, you know, in all fairness, we work pretty well as a team.
Yeah.
We're never going to see eye to eye. You know what I mean? Not when somebody lies to you and say you're doing 10 sprints and then you end up doing 20. You know, it's not nice, is it, really? Because in your head, you're thinking, right, I'll give it everything I've got for this 10. And then you're doing another 10. It's not nice.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's enough to push anybody over the edge.
Yeah.
But it just shows at the end of it that, hey, you've done it.
Yeah, I like it. Well, it's, look, we're really looking forward to this fight. It's going to be on DAZN, November the 5th. Make sure you tune in to watch it. Pat, hopefully we'll be doing a victory video at the airport on the way back.
Not hopefully, we will be.
We will be.
We will be. I'm very confident in Zelfa and what I see in Zelfa. I believe in Zelfa so much because, you know, I know where his journey's come from. I know it. I've been there from every step of the way, from when he put the gloves on to a kid, to watching be the developments, to being here now. I know it also. You know, I just know what his kid's capable of. And watching his opponent, yeah, I don't know anything about him, but what I do see of him, I say he's good. But good can only make us better.
Well, I'm off to watch some videos of him to have a little look, and I can't wait for this because it's an opportunity you guys have been waiting for a long time. It's come out of the blue, but it's here now to take with both hands, isn't it?
It is. I mean, it is. It's an opportunity that you probably only get. I mean, look, Zelfa stepped up when he fought for the European, and everybody said that was his best performance. Yeah, but then nobody's given Zelfa the chance to say what's his best performance is. Yeah. That was a good performance. Yeah, that wasn't his best performance. His best performance is yet to come. You know what I mean? You have to fight the best in order to be the best. That's what fighting for the world title is all about. Being a world champion. If you don't do it, then you just wasn't ready for it. You got to climb back that ladder again. But, you know, I do believe this is the time. He's won the European. Yeah, we could have made a European defence. But this has fell right on our lap. He's ready for it.
Brilliant. Wish you the very, very best of luck, Pat. And we cannot wait for the fight.
Neither can I, because I feel like I'm in camp myself.